Welcome to Cotak. In this tutorial, we will cover the basic agency administrator tools. Each agency that uses Cotak will have one or more agency administrators who are responsible for programming your agency's usage of Cotak. If you do not know who your agency administrator is or would like to become one, contact the Cotak project team at support@cotak.gov. Cotak is designed with local control in mind. Once you are an agency administrator, you will be able to create and manage users within your agency. You will also be able to create channels for use in the TAC apps within your agency. We will start by logging in to cotak.gov. Find the login button, click on it, and enter your email address and password. Remember that this is the same email address and password that you use to log into the TAC apps. Once you are logged in, you will see a button with your initials in the top right corner. If you tap on this and profile, you can change your name, email address, phone number, or update your responder type. The responder type field contains several options, and you can select more than one responder type based on your needs. The type of responder that you select will determine which channels you may have access to in TAC, so choose carefully. You can also update your password and enable two-factor authentication in this field. Next, we have the alarm bell. This is an option to see the notifications that are available to you. If a user requests to join your agency or you have other notifications, they will appear here as well as being emailed to you. Next, we have the agency administrator tools. If you administer more than one agency in Cotak, you have the option to switch between agencies here. However, most users will just see one agency. To change agency settings, tap on the button and select the appropriate option. You may rename your agency, change the prefix of your agency, add a description, or update your agency's address. You may also sign agreements through this field. Each agency utilizing Cotak is required to sign participation agreements. These can be e-signed digitally at any time. Most of the options across the top of the menu bar on our website are available to all Cotak users, whether you are an agency administrator or not. These include support tools, where you can file a help desk ticket, a downloads page where you can download content from Cotak, a My Cotak page where you can view the channels that are available to your user account, a data retention policy where you can see what data we retain and for how long, and the tool to join and create an additional agency. This tool is useful if you need to join multiple Cotak agencies as a responder. We also have training content on the various types of TAC, as well as a news and about page. The administrator tools are only visible to agency administrators in Cotak. The first tool we will cover is the users tool. Selecting this option shows a list of the users that are currently active within your agency. If you need to delete a user, if the personnel has been fired or quit your agency, you can select the trash can icon here to delete that user. You can also create a new user by clicking on the Create button. This will open a form where you enter the name and email address of the first responder you wish to join your agency. You must also enter a responder type for that user. To select a password for a user, most agency administrators will leave the switch for the assigned password in the left position. This will cause the system to automatically email the user and allow them to set up their own password. However, if you need to manually assign a password for a user, you may enter and confirm a password here. Once you click the Save Changes button, the new user will be notified by email and will be able to log into cotak.gov. The second way for users to join your agency is for them to sign up themselves at cotak.gov on the guest side of our website. A prospective user for your agency would navigate to cotak.gov and click on the sign up button. they will select the center option to request a new user account with an existing Kotak agency. First, they have to enter and verify their email address. Once they receive the email from Kotak, they will tap the register button and be brought to a form where they can enter more information about themselves. They will select which agency they wish to join. And then they will enter a name and a phone number. And select their responder type. Users can also enter additional information to help the agency administrator vet their request. Once you hit submit, your request for access will go to the agency administrator for vetting. As an agency administrator, you will receive an email notification that a user wishes to join your agency, and when you log into cotak.gov, you will see that the notification bell has a new notification. Click on this, and you will see the user request that's pending, and click the View button to vet it. You may review the request and accept or reject it at this point. Once you accept the request, the user will be able to become fully active in the Kotak system. The other administrative tool that you have access to as an agency administrator in Kotak is the Channels tool. This is where you program the channels that are accessible to your agency's responders in their flavor of TAC. You can create channels that are available to all of your agency's responders, or you can create channels that are only available to responders that you name. To create a new channel, select the Admin Tools and Channels. This will show you the available channels that currently exist within your agency by default. To create a new channel, select the Create button, name the channel, and select the visibility of this channel. Visibility means that a channel can be discovered by another agency using Kotak. At no point are channels and their existence available to the general public, just to other Kotak agencies if you wish to mutual aid with them. This mutual aid capability will be covered in a later video. If you wish the channel to be discoverable by other Kotak agencies, select the public option. Otherwise, select the private option if you want the channel to be completely invisible to all other responders in Kotak, or agency if you just wish for your agency to be able to discover the channel. The TAC description field allows you to enter text that displays in the TAC app next to the channel's name. Keep this text short because space is at a premium in the TAC apps themselves, but this may be a useful way to describe the purpose of this channel to your responders. You may leave a longer description in the description field if you wish to leave notes for yourself on the website. This information does not pass into the TAC apps. This option below for channel membership allows you to set how responders can see your channel. Bear in mind that any channel in Kotak, a responder has to manually turn the channel on or off to actually activate it in the TAC apps. The channel membership field merely determines if responders can join the channel if they wish to. The easiest option here is to select all users, which, as the name implies, ensures that every user within your agency has access to turn that channel on. The other option is managed, where you can add a responder one at a time by name. The third option for responder type is kind of a medium option where any responder of a certain type is automatically added to the channel. Remember that every user in Kotak has one or more responder types associated with them, and so if they have a responder type that matches the responder type of the channel, they will automatically be added to the channel. Once you're done, select Save Changes. To edit an existing channel or add users to a channel, navigate back to the main Channels menu in Kotak. This will display the list of current channels that are active within your agency. Tap the pencil icon to edit the channel. Again, you can change any of the values that you initially set when you created the channel. Note that if the channel has automatically created membership, if it's an all users channel or a responder types channel, you will not have the ability to see a list of users because that list is derived automatically. However, if you select a channel that is managed, where you add users in one at a time by name, if you tap on the pencil tool, you will see a list of users if you tab over to it. Here, you can add users to a channel one at a time by name. This is useful for sensitive operations, such as a SWAT team or drug task force, or just for teams of small groups of responders where not everybody in the agency has a need to know. To add users to a channel, select the Add User to Channel button and search for a name. You can attach a user, or you can attach and add another user if you need to plug and chug. To delete a user from a channel, simply tap on the red remove option next to that user's name and they will be detached from the channel. This concludes the basic agency administrator tutorial, powered by the Colorado Department of Public Safety and the Center of Excellence for Advanced Technology Aerial Firefighting. To learn more, visit cotak.gov.